Hey everyone, it's December 14th. The hardwood is heating up. Are you ready? I am. This is The Scene with me, Jane Slater.
National Signing Day is tomorrow, and there are a lot of commitments, decommitments, and recommitments to keep up with. Oklahoma landed Florida commit Nick Evers on Monday. The four-star QB from Flower Mound, Texas, decommitted from the Gators last week. Meanwhile, the Sooners' rival, the Texas Longhorns, landed highly coveted transfer Quinn Ewers. Ewers was previously the number one recruit in the 2022 class before skipping his senior season and enrolling at Ohio State and earning endorsement money. One of those endorsements, a Columbus car dealership. They bid Quinn a fond farewell as he heads home to the Lone Star State. As for some other prospects who were featured on Sports Stars of Tomorrow, Gabriel Brownlow-Dindy, a five-star defensive end from Lakeland, Florida, has flipped from Oklahoma to Texas A&M. And linebacker Jaishawn Barham from St. Francis Academy in Baltimore announced a commitment to South Carolina. Meanwhile, his teammate Derrick Moore, a former Oklahoma commit, will announce his commitment on Wednesday. Several other top recruits will be announcing commitments tomorrow, including Earl Little Jr. from American Heritage in Plantation, Florida. The All-American defensive back is expected to sign with either Alabama, Florida State, Oregon, or Miami. Be sure to tag Sports Stars of Tomorrow in your signing day post tomorrow. It was a memorable couple of days for Modern Day High School in California. On the same weekend the Monarchs' former QB Bryce Young won the Heisman Trophy, the current team won the CIF Open Division Championship with a 44-7 victory over Sarah High School. The win not only gives Modern Day a state title, but it also all but locks up a national title, as the Monarchs have been a wire-to-wire number one in the national rankings. Elsewhere in the national top five, Collins Hill High School won the Georgia 7A state championship, its first in school history. Led by Florida State commit Travis Hunter and Missouri quarterback commit Sam Horn, the Eagles finished their season 15-0 and stay put at 3 in the latest Max Preps Top 25. The Texas 6A Division II semifinal had a lot of people's attention, including Chicago Bears teammates Andy Dalton and Nick Foles, who posted a photo wearing their respective high school colors. In the game itself, the nation's second-ranked team, Austin Westlake, defeated 7th-ranked Katy 45-14. Clemson commit Cade Klubnik had 300 yards passing and 5 touchdowns. Westlake goes for a third consecutive state title this weekend against Denton Guyer in what will be the final game for Westlake head coach Todd Dodge, who is retiring after the season. There is no better way to end your season than with a Hail Mary to win the state title. In Virginia, Stonebridge High School did just that. Jacob Thomas hit Ezekiel Wimbush for the game winner as Stonebridge defeated Maury 27-21 to win its second consecutive state title. Finally, an incredible performance in girls basketball. Hannah Cohn of Hagerty High School in Florida set a national record by hitting 19 three-pointers in one game. She had 61 points on the night. She told local TV station WESH that after she hit 11 threes in the first half, her teammates told her to go out in the second and make some history.
Someone looked it up at halftime and was like, the record is 17. And so we all came together and my coach was like, okay, we're getting this record. Like, this is the game to do it.
Be sure to follow Sports Stars of Tomorrow on all of our social media channels for bonus content and previews of our upcoming episodes. And visit our website to check out all of our latest features. I'm Jane Slater, and I'll see you back here next week on The Scene. Thanks for checking out this video on our YouTube channel. And while you're here, go ahead and hit that subscribe button and browse for more Sports Stars of Tomorrow.